Hey, what's going on, everyone? I'm back. I apologize for missing out for a couple weeks. If you've never seen these videos, if you've never seen any of my videos, my name is Alex. I'm a student Hack Reactor. I'm doing the remote version, meaning that I'm not in class in person. Everything's online. There's some ups and downs. I will probably make a video eventually talking about like my experience, all my experience in doing remote, and if I think like being in person would have been differently. I don't know, like I think that we can be interested in making a video. But for now, I do apologize for not making any videos from week 8, 9, and 10. But I was just... This last project was very time consuming. I'll go into detail more about the project. But we were from week 8, 9, and 10. We work in the same project. The project's called SDC. It stands for System Design Capstone. And in this project, each group, because we're still working in a group, we get to decide which project we want to take over. So our group took someone else's project and work on it. I think I mentioned in the previous video that I was only responsible for making a module, right? So each person in the group, I'm gonna make like a square right here. Each person in the group working on each like component of a page, right? So now it was my turn to get a different module, so like a different component, and optimize it, make it more efficient. But most importantly, going from 100 records. So my previous application, I only had 100 records, meaning that I was only showing 100 products, right? I was only showing. If you think about a website, you know how you can do like a slash at the end, like, you know. So we only had from 1 to 100, so there was only 100, I guess, only 100 pages created, or whatever you want to call them, records, right? That's a good example. So now we went from 100 to 10 million records. So I learned a lot during these 2 weeks. It was fun, entertaining, stressful. I don't know, there's so many different verbs and adjectives that I can probably describe this project. But yeah, like it's a little bit overwhelming at some times. Sometimes there wasn't a lot of things going on. I'll just mention a couple examples, right? So, for example, we needed to use two new databases. For the whole time, we've been using MongoDB. Mongo, because, you know, Mongo is pretty common among, you probably hear the word MERN, you know, like Mongo, Express, React, and Node. So we're used to using Mongo, but now, or Mongo or SQL, usually it's Mongo or SQL, the ones that were the most common ones. But I needed to use two different databases that I had not used in the past. So I decided to go with Postgres and Cassandra. So another person in my group uses Neo4j, I think. Someone else uses Skyla. Different databases, the names doesn't matter. But we needed to compare those two databases and see which one was faster. Stress test the modules with all the information from the database. I guess like something important that I learned. It's just because, you know, like, it hadn't happened before that I'm able to, you know, like, generate data on my SQL or any database that I have, because I'm normally working with like small sets of data. I don't know, like, let's say like the biggest has been like 1,000 records, so not a lot of information on my database, you know, like, still kind of small. But for this presentation, I learned how much memory I needed to have, right? So my computer, I mean, I've known since the beginning of Hack Reactor that I did not have enough space as far as memory, just because I have a lot of files. I used to work in finance. I know that sounds so annoying, like when I said that, like, oh, I used to work in finance. So there's a lot of files that I feel like they're important for myself that I want to keep, because a lot of those files, I wouldn't say projects, but there's just some things that I worked in the past involving like large I mean, I have some portfolios that I had and information about like stocks and just stuff like that that I don't want to delete at this moment just because I want to keep it. You know, like it's just some research that I did in the past, you know, like basically from college and all those things. So my just forget it, right? My computer was kind of full already of information, not a lot of useful information, I guess. But I knew I needed to like clean up my desk and I did not. So I learned the hard way when my database was being seeded, meaning like I was passing information into my database, or I ran out of space because I did not have enough space in my desk. So yeah, like I mean this project, I'm not gonna really explain too much into the project, but it was time consuming because, you know, like you needed seeding the database. It took me like an hour, to do it, like just on SQL. Postgres took me like another 20. I think another database took me like 30 minutes, and then I have to drop my databases because they were not the way I wanted to come out. So yeah, I mean, it was just, honestly, like managing the time wasn't super great. You know, like I did feel like I made a couple mistakes along the way. I learned a lot from this project, but there were some things that I wish I probably would have done differently. And we have so many deliverables, I guess deliverables. Yeah, that's you probably get the idea. So, for example, every 2 days we were supposed to turn in something. So, like the first, like it started pretty easily. I mean, easily, that's not a word. It started pretty simple, like just picking up your 2D. Like, for example, the first deliverable, pick your 2 databases that you're gonna use. So, I made some research, I went with Postgres and with Cassandra. The next deliverable, see your databases, right? See them with like information, only 100 records. There you go. So do it the next day. The next day, make a crude API. You know, meaning like you can create, create, read, update, delete information from each database that I'm using. So from Postgres, from SQL, from Mongo, from like the databases that I'm using, make it happen. So it basically like every 2 days we had so many like things coming up and we had a lot of meetings as a team, right? Like for example, my team needed my information. So in the morning, like 9 a.m, we will have like a small meeting with the team. Now start working, then someone else had something else. And also, there's been a lot of emphasis into doing research as far as jobs, like job search after Hack Reactor. So my time has been like, apologize. I did know that I wanted to make videos. But first of all, my files were taking much of my space. So like, I only had 40 gigabytes left. So, you know, like before seeding one of my databases, so I ended up with only like 10, 15 gigabytes free. So I did not want to make videos or edit videos because, you know, like that was gonna take space that I might need for something else. So that's kind of why I postponed making videos, but I'm back now making videos since basically that's over. I don't have to do it again. I mean, I might have to in case after they review my work, they might tell me to go back and do more work, but I feel like, yeah. Yeah, that's basically, that's it for as far as the project that we work on from week 8 to 10, right? So that's all I'm gonna mention about the project. As far as other, what do you call it, another remarkable experiences that I've done during Hack Reactor, right? Like besides that, I mean, from week 8 to 10. Oh, actually, it was pretty cool because we had a full day of creating your resume, like updating it, making it better. If you've been in the industry, like in software engineering industry, it's probably like a waste of time for you because you don't need this, right? Like you're fine, like you're already working in the industry, so you whatever you say, like it has, you'll be fine, you know, like you already work as an engineer, so that's fine for you. But for someone else like myself, I'm not gonna say it again, but you know, like I work in finance, so I do not have my resume, like does not look like a resume for like an engineer. So we had a full day of just editing and making our resumes better. I do have a complaint though. That's all we did for the day. So we started like around 10:30, I think. 10:30, yeah, like around 10:30. We basically created a team from scratch, added a couple things. Then like after an hour, we worked with someone else. Like that person took over my resume, like took over, like see what if I could make it better. Then I worked on it for another 30 minutes. Then I give it back to someone else. And then we had a meeting with like a career coach. Then someone else looked at my resume. I don't know. It was just a very like busy day that I feel like I did not have a lot of creativity going on just because I don't know, like, I do feel like basically putting, like, working on something under, like, an hour, it's kind of tough, you know, like, I wish it would have given us, like, 3 hours, 2 hours, is like, you know, like, spread out, instead of just 30 minutes, work on it, meet with someone, work on it again, meet with someone else, watch a video about, like, I don't know, something else about a video, then work on something else, I mean, work on the resume again, meet with someone else, more feedback. It was just kind of like broken down, like, into many things going on, so I do feel like I have to, like, the next day I had to go back and myself and make some changes, but I'm happy, you know, because I do feel like the product came out nicely, and I do yeah, I mean, if you're an engineer, you're probably thinking like, oh my god, did you pay $20,000 just to get a resume, like an engineer resume? I mean, obviously, like, you know, like, that's not it, but, you know, like, that's, I mean, you can look at it that way, right? Like, we spend, like, all this money just to get our resume, like, making it look more engineering. But, you know, like, that's just something that I wanted to talk about. As I mentioned, like, every Monday we have, like, a small test, like, you know, like, they're called self-assessments, where we basically, we're testing our knowledge. We're testing to see if we're actually do know what we do know, like, or there's anything else missing from, I guess, from us. So they're actually getting, like, they're being more of, I feel like they're tougher, like, they're harder, but they're also, like, easier in a way, you know, like, they're more realistic. Like, if, for example, one of them was, like, to build the front end of an application, right? Like, I mean, you get instructions, so you gotta build the front end. And for the next week, you were supposed to build the backend, you know, like the server, all those things. And the next one, so week 8, week 9, and week 10, that one was a little tricky because there was a lot of things going on that one. But yeah, I mean, they're actually cooler, you know, because before, like, our self-assessments were involved in things that were kind of like, I don't know, like working on... I forgot the word, like asynchronous code and just callbacks and stuff like that, you know, like stuff that wasn't really super cool, you know, like, I mean, it's still nice to know, but I feel like actually, like, our self-assessments, they're getting, like, they're more realistic and enjoying more. What else do I have? I don't think I have anything else. Yeah, honestly, I do not have anything else. I'm looking into these things and blah, 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 blah. I'm reading some notes, actually. Yep, nope, nothing else. So, yeah, this is probably going to conclude my video. Lastly, I wanted to say that I forgot to mention that everything that we did got deployed into AWS. You know, like, we actually send it into the cloud, and from the cloud, you needed to do a lot of things, such as making queries, data generation, sitting in your database. So there was a lot of things to it. And you have to pay for this project also. Like, that's another thing, because Amazon, obviously, like, they're not gonna let you use their servers for free. Like, they're not gonna let you. Like, I know people say, like, they are, but when you're uploading, like, 40 gigabytes of database, like, because I use 2 databases, right? And another 5 gigabytes of pictures and information, you have to pay. I ended up, my total cost for my ACC project was $14. I mean, it's not bad, you know, like, because I was actually using one of their faster servers, because to speed up things. My other guy, and my other, this guy in my group, who just told me, like, dude, just pay for, like, a large micro server. And so my total cost for the project was $14. So that adds to my coding bootcamp. I guess the total cost is now $2,014. But hopefully it's a good investment. I do feel like I have learned quite a bit. So this concludes the video from, I guess, week 8, week 9, and 10. I will make a video about week 11, and after that, like, I'll make another video, and I'll keep making videos, and I'll tell you guys I'll keep making videos about something, you know, like, if you have any question, just hit me up, you know, like, I do feel like I've been replying to a couple of you guys, So if you guys have any questions, just please don't hesitate. Just hit me up and I'll get back to you as soon as I can, okay? All right. See you later, guys. Enjoy your weekend. Take care.